thanks to the management, faculty, dean, and students of St. Paul Institute who have invited me and to share my views and to be here to know that this kind of professional school with a lot of depth, knowledge and experience are happening now. And I have always been professing for so many years that India needs minimum 1,000 students, 1,000 institutes all over India if we have to raise the standard of thinking, mentality, civilizations, culture, and which we are suffering all the time. And I'm very happy to be here with you. And I always thought, for a change, Mr. Nasruddin Shah will speak first and then I will copy him. But he has given me the responsibility to talk about it. Well, I think we all know what education means. And we all know that how media education is so important in today's terms, when the communication has become so easy, from king to pauper, a poor man to prime minister, you can communicate. But what you want to communicate, media is a device, and we are having tools, technology, which we are training students here. But what we are communicating is the most important part of our education. This is what I always feel. What is the content? What is the thought? What is the philosophy behind it? Is more important than the tools. Technology and tools will always happen and come. Hamesha, they will always give you surprise. Whether my mother was writing me a 5 pages letter to me, which I used to preserve and used to read twice, and used to get the best of the things from her and uplift my life. Now I'm getting SMS from my daughter and my wife, you see, that I feel that she is too restless and too quick to tell me anything in 140 words and 200 words. So what I feel the technology has brought us to the easy and fastest communication, but what we are losing is the soul part of it. You see, and that we have every teacher, every school must keep this in mind, that we are responsible not to teach only the technology or the best of technology and with facilities or tools. We have to build them as a human of that kind, which is, we call it an ideal man. So unless and until we build them up as a person, how they should think, they should not depend on the technology. Most important thing is not a knowledge. Most important thing is intelligence and wisdom and spirituality. Most important thing is a soul. Even I perform, Nasruddin performs. Why he is the greatest actor today? Because he performs through soul. They are more handsome and they are taller people than him. But he, when he performs, he performs. Yes. And why I am a super hit director? Because I perform through soul. Yes. Thank you. It's a mutual admission society we have. Nasir happens to be my junior from Pune Institute, so we are friends and we love each other. And trust me, I cannot forget when I have formed an institute, set up an institute like Wesley Woods, and I'm proud of it. More than whatever movies I made, good, bad, ugly. But I'm more proud of that I have established and set up an institute. And it would be with that quality. That Nasir was the first person. He was the first person to support me when the building was under construction and I brought him there. And he said, well, this is called a real beginning. This is called a real attempt. And I am going to do that. And he set up our acting, set up our their acting studio, acting classes. And he devoted his time for 3 years constantly. And he did not charge a single rupees. Can you beat that? In spite of me being a rich. So And when such people come, bring such people to your institute. Bring people who are meaningful, who understand the importance of this kind of genuine training. Let us not make a mushroom school just for money, just for money. You are responsible for the, you are the real architect of the next generation. When you say the younger generation is architect of India, but you are the architect of the younger generation. How you develop them? I always blame teachers. I always blame institution and education system for what we are facing today. Whether in the terms of politics or in terms of communication or in journalism or parliament or whatever is situation today we are facing is because of the very defective educations we have been brought up. We have never been told the right things. Anything basic things you need, really. We have today 2 lakhs unemployable MBAs in the industry. They have a diploma or degrees, but the bosses of the company says that we have interviewed them. They are not employable, they can't communicate. I cannot give them job at the risk of my company. They have degrees and diploma, but they can't stand any question. They can't face any kind of crisis. They can't solve any problem. They have solved only those 6 questions in their exam and passed out. That's it. They don't know the 7th question. So this is our responsibility at institute. Teachers or whatever institution or a management, that we should be, we are responsible for his bringing up. It's like that you are the parents, at least you are educated parents. You are not emotional parents who will accept every weakness of his child and ask him to grow the way he wants to grow. So you have, and we have more responsibilities towards our children. And I'm sure that looking into the quality of the faculty members and you joining us the same way, the way we are also trying at Whistling Woods. And I wish you all the best. Anything from me, my side, from Nasir's side, I can tell you, we are always there to be with you, to guide, to participate, or give suggestions. Accept money.